What is good, guys? This is Ghost Fighter, Too Tease, and you know I'm back with that new video. I apologize, guys, because I'm not able to upload on my standard video upload that I normally use. There's something wrong with my YouTube and my connection on my PlayStation 4. I've been trying to deal with it for the past couple days, can't figure it out. But I'm about to bring you the best all around sharpshooter build. I kid you not, guys. I went to the park last night. I played probably about 25 games, and I'm gonna tell you, I was grabbing boards. I have nothing but maybe one rebound bar. I was freaking just terrorizing people, chase down artists from behind. I was pulling down rebounds. I was shooting long range shots, and I had no badges on. All my shots were like almost green lights every time with no badges. Haven't played one career mode at all at that point. I hadn't. So I'm gonna show you the best build that's gonna be able to give you the dribble moves. You're gonna be able to do everything that you would normally do with your archetype when you build a point guard, but when you build a sharpshooter, but at its best. So first, you're gonna pick a point guard. Bam. Then you know you're gonna go over the sharpshooter, of course. Very simple. And then, guys, you're not gonna make them this small. You're not gonna do this. Now, I did see a guy at the park that was 5'7". You can see how it makes your speed, your steal, your lateral quickness, your vertical, your driving ball, your off dribble, your off shot mid. All that's cool, but you're going to get blocked or contested by someone that's taller than you by at least six inches. Most people don't make shooting guards really small. Now, I can't say that if you're not running with a glass cleaner, a slasher. You being the little guy shooting the threes may be okay, but if they figure you out and lock you down and you're 5'7", it is not going to work. So you want to make your guy 6'7", dog. I'm not kidding you. You want to make him 6'7". Your standing dunk go up, your driving dunk go up, your contact dunk go up. Box out, defensive rebound, offensive rebound, block. Do you see this? You see how big those yellow bars are. I just want you guys to know that this is the best build, because you're going to be able to bang with the best of them that's rebounding down in the paint. Now, your wingspan. Now, of course, people say make them a midget and this goes up, but that's not consistent enough to have a little wingspan, man. You mean to tell me LeBron's going to reach on you and take everything from you, all your cookies, every time you dribble? So the best thing you can do is extend it all the way out. You want the longest reach possible, man. I'm telling you, dude, I was chasing down people. I feel like a center on the court. I'm not going to lie to you guys. I feel like a center on the court. I'm not lying to you, but fast. Now you got the longest wingspan, and now you're gonna go to weight. People say, if you make him higher, then he contact dunk. You're not trying to contact dunk. You got a sharpshooter, so lower that weight, bruh, all the way down to about 180. You see what goes up, though? Look how thick those bars are. Speed, acceleration, vertical, lateral, speed with ball. Come on, man. I'm trying to help you guys build the best sharpshooting point guard. God, I'm trying to tell you. And then you're going to advance. You know you want them arms to get wider, because it's going to just give you more. It's going to give you just, I'm telling you, man, it's just going to make you, if you make this build and you go play it, don't put anything on your character and go play at the park. And I guarantee you, you're not going to regret it. You're going to want to play with this guy all the time like I do now. I did not know this build was so good till I saw a video, and I can't remember who to get the props to, but he showed me the video, and I haven't been disappointed since I made mine. So now you're going to advance at the 23.1 with your shoulder width, and then you're going to make him a lefty. Because honestly, I feel like left-hand shooters suit so much better than right-hand shooters. That's just my preference. That's just what I think. And then you want to advance after making them a lefty. And you know you want to go with that number. You're trying to be a guard out here. That 30. Let's get into it. So now that I've shown you how to make your archetype, how to build him, how to stretch him out, making him a point guard, he's going to have all the dribble moves. Now, we're going to get into the stats of what he has. All right, guys, we're back. So here we are, and I played one game, and you can see what I scored in one game. The short shooter is OP. Limitless range, catch and shoot, mid-range dead eye, corner specialist, all on Hall of Fame. Who gonna stop you? So this is the first thing you should do. You should come down here, go to option and appearance. Okay, just listen me out, and now back out of it and hit X. Okay, and that's gonna allow, when you go to your option menu, it's gonna allow you to change your game speed. And I want you to make sure you got this right before you start. So you want it on rookie, 12-minute quarters, 100 game speed. It don't matter the jersey number. And then action replay, put it on never. And after basket camera cut, never. That way you don't take all that time messing around. Then you can put it on name and position. And you can have your shot meter or whatever on. And in the game, I kind of turn the crowd volume down because sometimes it gets out of pocket. So I kind of turn the crowd volume down, but everything else can stay all the way up. And then in-game music, I kind of got it around 50. And other than that, so now you can back out of that. And I'm going to show you how your coach settings, you want it on, all play, full, show all, and then manual. So you can do your own stuff. And then you're going to come over here to controller settings. You're going to have it the vibration on, default for pro stick. Absolute, and then on, absolute, flashy, who to guard, on. You always want it on when you're playing my park, I feel like, because you need to know who you're guarding, and you don't get all mixed up and then piss off the people you're playing with and mess around and not be able to get back on. And then automatic shot contest, I put it on intense D. If you don't want it on intensity, you can always put it on manual, and you can just kind of, you know, automatic contest when you want to. You can put it on intensity so it doesn't pull you. And then I just put it, some people put it on always, but I would say either manual or intensity. You could try it on always. And then target position, I put it on custom. And you want to go 90 on pass target direction. And you want to go 70 on pass target distance. And then you want to go pass target openness. You want to put it on about 60. And then you want to back from that. And I'll be back and I'll show you the attributes. Okay, guys. So here's the stats. And to start your sharpshooter out, you want to automatically straight away, you want to max out the defense, which are out of your upgrades they give you. Max out your defense, max out your playmaker, and so you don't get the ball stripped from you. They made me put the one rebound on, so that's fine. My rebound is around 40-something, but I'm going to max that out. You really don't need strength because you're not going to be trying to back nobody down in the paint, but you do want your rebound all the way up. So once you get, you got a 95, those are the rest of the bars you should be putting on as rebounder. You want your agility all the way up, okay? That gets you to around 74, and then if you got boost, you're around 79 with the ball, which will give you all the dribble moves. And then, of course, you see that. 3-point, even though your legs are all the way, your arms are all the way extended out, your shoulder width is all the way extended out, guys. It still gives you a 91. With boost, it's a 96. You're not going to miss if you got the right jump shot on. And then you see mid-range shooting. Oh, my gosh. 91. 96 with the boost. And then dunks, you really don't have to worry about. I was dunking good, guys, because I'm really tall. I'm 6'7", with the longest wingspan and arm span. So I was dunking the ball really quick before they could even get to me and do anything to me, guys. I'm telling you, it is worth you to make your build this way. I promise you, you will not regret it. So this is what you should upgrade, exactly, if you want to pause it and look at it. But defense, playmaker, agility, 3-point shooting, mid-range shooting. You want all those max to begin with. And then you could put a bar or two, like I did on layup and dunks. And I think my shoot-off dribble is already there. But you want to, when you get your other upgrades, you want to max out your shoot-off dribble. And you want to max out your layups. I mean, your layups and dunks. So just so you can finish around the rim real good. And once those are leveled up, then you want to just put the rest on rebounder. Because honestly, you don't need strength with a sharpshooter. You're just trying to grab the snag the rebound. You don't need to be trying to post nobody up in the paint. You're playing your archetype wrong if you're doing that. So this is Ghost Fighter, 2 T's. Sorry I didn't have my original stuff to do my video on, but please, guys, make sure you support me. I'm trying to support you guys and give you guys the best information. Make sure you like, subscribe for more videos to come. And I'll even go and show you the attributes so you can kind of know what you're getting from your architect for your sharpshooter. Okay, guys, and as you start the game, you want to start building up your hot spots. Okay, as you can see, I played one game. I'm 13 for 22 from the top right. I'm 8 for 18 from the corner. I'm 7 for 9 from that corner. And this will kind of tell you how many shots you need to get your corner specialist and stuff like that. So I made 8 and 7 in that one game from the corner. So that'll kind of give me an indication of how many corner specialist shots I need to get my badge so I can make it gold. But you want to get all your hot spots all around the court. And then I'll kind of show you. I got one badge, Espresso. I just started. And I'm scoring 100 points. That first game, I scored 100 points. No lie. All right. So you can see the overall. Close isn't that good. I'm not sure why. I guess close meaning right around the rim. But, I mean, when you get your layups and your dunks, you can maybe make that better. But shot mid-range. Look at that. 91. You might as well not shoot close. You might as well shoot midi. 91. Contested shot mid, 91. Open shot mid, 3. 91. Contested shot 3 is still a 91. Come on, guys. Like, seeing the shot off dribble and shot 3 off dribble, that's why you want to max that bar out, because you're going to better come down and pull up without them trailing you and trying to block you from behind. You know, my dunk and my layup and all that stuff isn't that great, but once I max everything out, guys, I'm telling you, this guy's height, everything is going to make him a beast. I'm telling you guys. You can get your stamina all the way up and your potential. See, it's at 90. You can get your intangibles and your stamina all the way up by getting Tyler Score. You do that by doing, off the dribble, like spin layups into the lane, and you'll get Tyler Score. All right, guys, this is Ghost Fighter. I hope that this video informed you and helped you. This is my 6'7", 180-pound God. I'm telling you, 6'7", sharpshooter. Get you one, bruh. And I'm out.